My parents were Muslim, so I grew up as a Muslim. My father was a devout Muslim. My father was, he was a good man, he was a simple man. He took us to the mosque every Friday. He demanded that we do the five prayers and we be there on Friday, and we did. I enjoyed it, we enjoyed it. Our father was doing it, so we were doing it. So there was a sense of security in it. We never thought about who Allah is, what Allah is all about, what is the history between Allah and man. And all we know about Allah, God, is what the Quran told us we should know. And it was not a bad thing. Islam was not a bad thing, because I didn't know any better or anything else. Since I was young, I had questions. I've always considered myself as somebody who liked God. I liked God. I enjoyed reading the Quran and the books that were written, and the hadith of Muhammad and all of his ways and sunnah and all of that. I excelled in it. I enjoyed it very much. I had questions that seems nobody has the answer for. Once I came here to go to school, I met a lot of students on campus who were actively speaking of Christianity and speaking of Jesus. Of course, I've always thought that I have the knowledge that I need to have about Jesus, because the Quran specifically speaks of what Jesus is and who Jesus is. So all of these people who are talking about Jesus being the Son of God, and being the Lamb of God, is they're misled. That's what the Quran speaks about. They're misled. So I consider them that way. Until one day, there was a knock on my door. I came downstairs, I opened the door, and there was this man, and there were two men, and they were passing these little booklets about who Jesus is and the salvation of Jesus, and all that Christian stuff. So I decided to correct them. I decided to take them on in a conversation. And one of them said that they don't have time for the conversation. And the other one said that they will meet up with me later that night down by campus. I did not think he was going to be there. I happened to be on campus that night, 7 p.m. I went by to that place where we were supposed to meet, and sure enough, he was waiting for me there. So we sat down, we talked, and we developed a friendship. It was some of the reasons why I decided to look into this Christianity, other than what the Quran says about Christianity, was the Christian people, in particular that person who I met, who we became friends with. It was how genuine they were, and what they believe about their God, and how what they wanted to do is to just share that knowledge with me. And they would go the distance to do that, which I thought was neat. A lot of events took place as well. They were telling me things about praying to God, talking to God, and having God being present when you talk to Him, which is almost blasphemy, and when it comes to the teaching of Islam. I tried it, and to my amazement, I asked God for a prayer, and I even put Him to the test, which I know I'm not supposed to, but I did. And I told Him, if He grant me this prayer, I will believe in Jesus. And in the back of my mind, I thought He will never do that, because He doesn't exist anyway, this Christian God. To my amazement, the next day, that exact same prayer that I asked Him to grant for me happened right before me. And that was the first blow that broke the fence outside that was built up by Islam. I did not believe in Jesus after the event happened, because I thought it was too easy. God never let up. From that day on, he kept on seeking me. I think he was seeking me before then. And I just think it's a neat thing. It's a neat thing that the God of the universe, who created the whole earth and the heavens, will care for a little one like me, to a point where he would specifically listen to me and specifically answer my prayers. Months pass by, and I'm researching and talking to more Christians, and many Christians were asking me to take in Jesus in as my Savior, which I didn't understand exactly what that means. Most of my friends were Christians, or the people that I were attracted to were Christian. People who I was interested in being with were Christians. Again, I decided to put God to the test. So I prayed with a friend of mine that Jesus will come into my life. And I said, God, I will surrender my life to you. And it's been since that day that God put this peace in my heart that I've never experienced before. There was peace between me and God. And it seems like the rest of life issues fell in place where they need to be, which I thought was very neat. God was kind to me during this time. Even when I went against him, he was kind with me. He always kept me safe. He gave me the time that I need to understand what he wants from me. And I thought that was really neat. That again, this God of the universe will care so much about me. I was relating to the word of the Bible because I was experiencing things, these big things, when they say that the Holy Spirit indwelled in them, which is strictly Christian language, because that is not in the Quran. But if the Holy Spirit of God is inside of you, inside your heart, that's a wonderful thing, that God is with you, which is what the name Emmanuel, the Christ, is. That's what it describes, as God with us. So it's, I trusted God for his promises, and he always fulfilled his promises. He's always faithful. And that's kind of neat, that you know God, you know these characteristics of God that Islam does not offer. Christianity offers that. In truth, it offers it, not because it's an appealing thing. I thought that was neat. I thought that was really neat. God compelled me in many ways. He made me happy. He put joy in my heart, and he answered my questions. All I know is I'm in God's hand. So I hope that what he gave me, this life that he gave me, I hope I can be a good steward with it. Whether I can share the gospel or help people in one way or another, I think it's important that if you have a lamp, you're not going to put it under a cover. You're going to take it and put it on top of the mountain. My sister asked me, she said, why do you want to tell people about your new faith? What's a big deal about your new faith? It is a big deal. It is the truth. That's why I want to tell people about it. You know, I struggle with Islam and Muslims and bringing Muslims to God, because I was very stubborn. I was a very stubborn Muslim who would not let go, because I always thought that Islam was the truth. And when that became, when the reality showed, when the truth became evident that it's otherwise, I was devastated, because I've always thought that I had the truth. But can you imagine living a life that you think is in truth, but it turns out that it's not? God offers truth. God offers salvation. I pray that God will direct me in a way, or open some kind of avenue for me, that I can go and speak to Muslims who will maybe just put the seed out, that sometimes, somehow, in their life, just like it happened to me, that seed will become a tree, a living tree. I invite my Muslim friends to pray to God and ask God to show them direction, just like He did for me.